generate some saving. Otherwise, you may apply too much glue and get too much squeeze out.
Yeah. You apply it to both surfaces if you're gluing?
Both surfaces, yes. Both surfaces.
So we're talking just a very thin coat of glue there.
Very thin, yeah. You see, you apply too much glue, then you actually waste the glue. The glue will be squeezed out. Yeah. And it will take extra longer time for the glue to dry. Because any glue we have a term called a solid rate. The Titebond original has about 46% of the solid, that means 54% is the water. Titebond 3 has 52% of solid rate, that means 42% is the water. Hmm. So the water takes time to evaporate.
That's interesting.
Yeah. And all the wood glue is called the PVA, polyvinyl acetate glue. So when you dry, it just looks nice, it's a plastic. So, do you think it's the plastic is easy to stain or easy to paint?
Easy to paint, no?
No. Nothing to stick to.
Trick question.
Very honest speaking, the plastic is not easy to paint, not easy to stain. So we never claim that our glues are easy to paint or easy to stain, because it's not true.
Question regarding the solid versus a liquid.
Yeah.
How does Titebond compare to what else is in the marketplace? Would Titebond be better than others when it comes to that rate of solid versus liquid?
Well, this is not a one good answer for this question, because the higher solid rate can make the glue less runny, right? You would stay on the surface better.
Yeah.
Then if lower solid rate, that means easier to spread, and the glue film will be very thin. So if you want to achieve a very thin glue line, you'll need a less viscosity, lower
solid rate. Yeah.
So that really depends on your application. Like a Titebond original is good for just the gentleman make the
mandolin.
Yeah, mandolin. Titebond original is widely used in the violin.
Mandolin.
Because the glue line is very thin. The viscosity is relatively low. So it's a little bit runny, but the glue line is very thin. Almost invisible. You can get almost invisible glue line. So, and secondly, it dries harder than Titebond 2 or Titebond 3. And the wood turning guys like to use the Titebond original because it dries harder. So there's no one good glue for everything. There always has a one product fit one application. So it really depends on what application is and what do you want. So
if you're just building a cabinet, then you would use Titebond original?
Yeah. If just indoor cabinets, Titebond original. If kitchen cabinets, Titebond 3.
For kitchen cabinets?
Yeah, kitchen cabinets is Titebond 3. Why? Because the kitchen cabinet is really close to the high moisture environment, and plus you have the dishwasher underneath. It's pretty hot, right? Pretty hot and high moisture level. So Titebond 3 is the most preferred glue to the kitchen cabinet guys. So those guys will either use the best glue or the cheapest glue. Yeah, they will use the white glue or the ordinary cabinet glue for the upper side of the closet. But the tabletop, the countertop, you will definitely use the Titebond 3.
It's interesting.
Yeah.
So why not just use 3 for everything?
It's expensive.
Expensive.
I like them to use everything, just use Titebond 3 for everything.
That's what I have in my shop.
Yeah. And the next term is about the open time. Some people say the 3 seconds, right? But some people want 15 minutes because that depends on the working time they want, right? So Titebond original give you 5 minutes open time. It means you have to work quick. Titebond 3 give you 15 minutes open time. So you have
for a couple of days.
Oh yeah. Yeah, no. 4 days like this.
He's not joking. He's telling you the truth.
Yeah. And the temperature is very important. For Titebond original, if the temperature lower than 10 degrees, it would take a longer time to dry. Then Titebond 3 can work as low as 7 degrees.
Wow.
Yeah, so it can dry at 7 degrees, but Titebond original, 15 degrees. Yeah. And Titebond 2 give you the open times 5 minutes. So this glue is also preferred by those wood flooring guys. So they use Titebond 2 to do the tunneling glue.
Yeah.
It's a great application on the hardwood flooring because it's a water resistant. Once you glue the tunneling glue, it will never fall apart. Yeah. In just 15 minutes, no way you can break apart the two pieces of boards.
Really?
Yeah. Wow. Because the open time is very short, only 5 minutes. That's what's from the 6 minutes, it starts to dry. And we have two packaging in the for the tunneling glue. One is this nozzle, and the other one is our nozzle is a very unique. It's just you don't need to have you don't need to keep the cap just like the other glue. But for the tunneling glues, some guys prefer the smaller nozzle to apply the glue in the groove. So
I have a question.
Yeah.
What's the melamine glue? Because a lot of the cabinet makers work with melamine, and melamine glue works very well. But how is it relating to
other melamine things? Is a type of plastic. So none of these not a polyurethane. None of these PVA glue can stick to melamine. So they only can stick to wood. But melamine glue is designed to stick the melamine and the wood, melamine and MDF, melamine and HDF, plus the particle board. Oh. And some HDF and MDF, they have a kind of like a film at the edge. But once you drop a water on the top, if the MDF or the HDF can absorb the water a little bit, that means there's no film. But if the water drop can running like a ball at the edge, that means that HDF or MDF, it has the film. So in that case, you need to send the film off and then apply the melamine glue. Huh? Otherwise, it would never stick. It would never stick. Because now the new products come out every day and no one will think about what the glues you could use, and that's our problem, right? So that's the real experience I got from those contractors. But why sometimes our melamine glue cannot work on those MDF or HDF? Why? And why some can work? Then we find out, okay, there's a film. They want to improve the water resistance of the HDF or MDF, so they apply a kind of a film. I have no idea what the film made is from, but that's really, really, really good water resistant film.
Type on 3 be used outside?
Yeah. Well, outside, so long as it's not submerged inside the water for 7 days, can be used outside.
Can it?
24 hours, 7 days, yeah.
Sorry, can it freeze?
Okay. If you send me the email, I will answer you no. Keep it away from the freezing. Because it's really tough to track the free thaw cycles, right? But most of our glues are free thaw stable for 5 cycles. Let's say you get this product really, really fresh from our warehouse, never freeze it in a row, and then you forget in the glue in your pickup truck. You can do it for 5 times. Better.
That's before use.
Yeah, before use.
So do you mean after use or before? Okay.
Oh, even
once you open it?
Even you have the half bottle, it's okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, because the water. I mean, all the wood glues, most of the products are good for 2 years, the shelf life. But even longer than 2 years, that doesn't mean the glue will fail. It will just becomes a little bit thicker.
So that's what the difference is. So if you see that it's a little thicker, it's longer than 2 years.
Yeah.
Now, do you normally put a production date on your bottles?
We have the local on the bottles.
So just never known the
water. So usually, you guys will either buy the wood glues from the Lee Valley or DZP or the other retailers. So in 2 years, all this glue will be gone, right? So no wood glue stay there for 2 years.
Home Depot or Lowe's doesn't carry that, does it?
No.
Okay, Peacock's does.
Canadian Tire,
no. I was in the Niagara woodworking show last year and this year. That was in Home Depot, and they don't sell any Titebond product. But I have a booth there, and it's really strange. And when the guys ask me where can I buy your product, I go to Lee Valley, go to BCB. Or even home hardware. About now 300 home hardware stores in Ontario sell our Titebond 2 and Titebond 3, and no run, no drip wood glues, and liquid high.
Do you have one in the Durham area that a dealer?
Peacock.
You see Home Hardware though?
I'm talking about Home Hardware though.
I'm not sure which one, but if you go to the Home Hardware store, you can ask for the Titebond glue and they will order for you.
Well, what I'm thinking is we could probably help you. If we could find a central dealer in Home Hardware that would carry the line, then we could all go to that one location and get it.
Busy
Bee.
Yeah, Busy Bee, you got to go all the way to Pickering, right?
No, to Pickering.
Or Peacock, okay.
What is it? What's the brown one?
Now, this one is
chocolate glue.
Yes. It smells like it's not. It's nothing like chocolate. This is a very old formula. It's from animal skin, and I heard some there's fish glue.
Oh, it's hide glue.
Hide glue. It's not from fish, but from animal skin.
So where would you use that?
This glue is called a reversible wood glue. When you give the high heat and spray some moisture, the bond will be released. So you can realign the bond, and once it cools down, it will bond again. And this product is good for the anti-furniture, or you want the glue line is in brown.
Okay.
You want a good match, the furniture is in dark brown, and you want to
turn it brown.
So
I buy translucent Titebond in the US. Yeah, do they sell that in Canada anywhere?
Translucent Titebond?
That's it dries clear. It's available. I found it in the States and I thought, oh.
Yeah, we can, our distributor can order for you.
Okay, from, no, I just buy one little bottle.
From US, but that's the not,
okay, it's not,
not very popular here.
Okay.
High is a very niche product. Home hardware only sells about 10 cases a year. But those violin guys, they love it. They, because they, from time to time, they need to realign their violins, so they need this group.
When you say violins, and you mentioned that a couple of times, do you mean any stringed instrument?
Not any. Yeah. But this all based on my experience. There's a one guitar company in China. They use Titebond original only to make all the guitar and violin. That's what I heard from the Woodstock woodworking show, the Hamilton woodworking show, and the Welbeck woodworking show. Mm-hmm. Those guys tell me they use this product in the violin.
Would those instruments be laminate or solid?